survived.
You did. Start with a big deep breath in. So we're gonna invite you now just to fill up those lungs. Big deep breath in through your nose, and we're gonna let it out through our mouth. So from that playlist that we did today, what would you say was your favorite song?
Oh, I think Staying Alive.
Right.
Is the one. Mainly because the Bee Gees did it. And I discovered the Bee Gees.
Oh my gosh.
About a year before they became famous. I was, it was in the mid-60s, and they'd not long been in Australia. They'd emigrated to Australia from England. And Barry was about 18, and his young brothers were about 13 or 14, and they came up to his armpits, and they were entertaining at this cafe that I ate at. And the following year, Channel 7 started Bandstand, which featured all people in the modern music. And whoa! So I like to say, yes, I discovered the Bee Gees.
All right, little bit of a change of pace. If you know the words, I invite you all to sing along. My singing voice isn't as good as my dancing, but there we go. Let's go. Let's go. Roll those shoulders. Oh, yeah. So lovely that you're helping the Dance Health Alliance with these videos.
I'm thrilled to be asked.
Thank you so much. What was your motivation behind helping us?
Well, when I first saw and heard about this idea, my dancer body is broken down. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I think it should be go out to a wider audience, because there are people that will want to do them.
Yeah, you came to a really big class. We had about 25 people in the class that you
I know. And out there's going to be a massive audience of men and women.
I think that's the thing, isn't it? It appeals to both men and women.
Yes, exactly.
It's not just for the
females. Everybody would like to dance. It's in our... You said it one time. It's in our DNA that we want to dance.
Yeah.
And there are people who have studied dancing, and others that just dance, whenever a new type of music came out, the dance floor would fill up with people, whether they could do the dances properly or not, because they loved it and they loved listening to the music.
Yeah. And I guess with this kind of program, there's no technique that you need.
Exactly, exactly. They're not frightened off, oh no, I couldn't, that's all too, yeah.
That's right, so there's no right or wrong. All right, dancers, we're going to do some brain training. Really important to keep your brain active. It helps ward off dementia. So the best way to do that is through brain training. Why do you enjoy dance as a form of exercise?
I'm not one of those people that gets up in the morning and does this and goes swimming and does that. I've never been, and I should have been, because I've been a dancer since I took tap and ballet lessons from 8 years of age, and had a song and dance act with my husband and danced in shows.
Yeah.
I should have been doing the normal exercises. It's not my style. I'm not the one to get up and say, where are the dumbbells? Pick them up and do, no.
Can relate.
The dancing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
And it's amazing how much exercise you actually get from doing
half
an hour.
Exactly. Yeah. You don't realise.
That's
right. You don't
right.
realise, because you're not thinking about it. You're listening to the music and the adrenaline is pumping.
Yeah.
And the music speaks to your soul.
So true. That is... All right, we're going to take one arm. We're going to go up, across. Let's go. Good. Two more. So what would you say was your favourite song?
Oh, it's hard to pick it all.
Like them all.
That I've performed and listened to. I can't pick out one precise one.
I actually was listening to Send in the Clowns on Spotify that you sung, and I have to admit, I had tears. It was an outstanding performance. I was just blown away with your depth of soul in that song.
Oh,
so
thank you.
I'm adding that to one of our playlists in future.
Oh, wow.
It was brilliant.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I've been terribly lucky, though my body's broken down, but I've still got the Hobson's choice. Yeah.
Definitely.
Thank you, dear Lord.
Bit of a swing. Oh, yeah. Good. We're going to take one arm and the other. I'm going to open it out. So if there's one piece of wisdom you would like to pass, or one motto that you live by, what would you say to everybody out there?
I say to all those that are out, whether you're young in your 30s or going into middle age or elderly, don't give up. There's always... we've lived through a world war. We've lived through the Vietnam and Korean War, and there's all sorts of things happening. And we've survived.
True.
And we'll survive this thing.
So true.
Don't give up. There's always tomorrow. And Winston Churchill said it.
Yeah.
And I'm living it. Never, never, never give up.
Now, there's only one word in this song, isn't that right? One word. One word we have to remember in this song. It's the important word. Tequila.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Yeah.
Mum sent me to tap and ballet classes when I was 8, and I loved it. I loved being with people and dancing to rhythm, and I found I naturally had rhythm, luckily. That's not everybody in the world has natural rhythm, but I loved it, and it gets the adrenaline pumping, and even though you're feeling, oh, what am I going to do, everything's gone, when that adrenaline pumps and everything's, it just sparkles you. It's the way nature has put us together, so that adrenaline can save us. Otherwise, we would all probably have bumped ourselves off by the time we were 16. Don't think about it. Oh, very much so. Yeah. Thank you. It transports me to a happy place.
Are you ready? If you know the words, feel free to sing along. Here we go. We're going to start by walking.
I was walking along, minding my business.
Here we go. Toni, there's one story you told me the other day, and I'd love you to share it with some of my teachers here, because some of my teachers are mothers and they can totally relate to it. And you mentioned your son, and you told me a beautiful story of in Melbourne at the festival with the bed that you thought he might go to sleep on, but he didn't because he was too busy.
Oh, the Moomba Festival.
Yes!
Which I think is closing this year or next year. But
right.
The Moomba Festival is a well-known Melbourne procession through, and it's a public holiday. We had just opened in the pyjama game,
yes,
my husband and I, at the Her Majesty's Theatre in Melbourne. And they decided to publicise the show. They had a gigantic double bed And if I'd known you were going to mention this, I'd have brought along the picture of it.
And next time.
Toni was, because Frank and I were in the show, Toni was not quite 2 years old. He was about 18 months old. And we decided to take him with us on the float. And the cast was on, it was about a pyjama factory, the pyjama game, if nobody knows what it's about. Doris Day made the movie of it. And Shrank's pyjamas, which were an American at the time, they made our pyjamas, and we had the publicity things of us were the white pyjamas with red hearts on them. And but Shrank's pyjamas made us pyjamas, and we took Toni on the float of the double bed because we couldn't get a babysitter. And we said, well, he'll probably sleep, you know. No, not a bit of it. He jumped up and down all through the procession, all through Melbourne. He danced up and down and entertained the people in the street. And Frank and I said, he's going to be in show business.
And
oh boy, has he.
Yeah.
He's a Broadway star. He went there with Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. And he was nominated for a Tony Award as Best Actor in a Musical. And he's my one and only darling son.
Yes, that's such a great
Toni
story.
Yeah.
Love that. Thank you. Well, I can't thank you enough for joining us today and sharing our gift of dance and movement and finding that freedom through movement. And that's what we're
thank
all
you.
About. So I really thank appreciate you being here and joining us. It means the world.
Don't ever give up.
All right, so we're going to go from our TV position to our dancing position. And sitting up nice and tall. Yeah. And your curtsy or your bow, dancers. You did very well. And up we come. And give yourselves a clap. A full 30 minutes of exercise. You did extremely well.
I survived.
You did. Staying alive. That's the important bit.
Yeah.
Well done, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good work.
Thank you.
Do you think there's an age limit to these dance classes?
Heavens no, I'm 88. I'll be 89 next March.
Wow.
And if I can do it, you can do it too. Don't say that, oh, I'm too old. No. And I can't walk upright without the use of my walker. So if I can do them, you can. No excuse.